Good afternoon, friends, and welcome to Fort Benning for day two of the second stage of the 2013 ISSF World Cup in Rifle and Pistol. We're kicking off the excitement today with 10-meter air pistol men. Just as a reminder of the new finals format, we have the top eight athletes who, after qualifications, enter into the final, where their qualification scores are erased and all start with a score of zero. 10-meter air pistol men consists of two series of three shots, which the athletes have 150 seconds for each series to shoot. This is followed by a single shot to be shot within 50 seconds. After the eighth shot, the athlete with the lowest score is eliminated, and this goes on through the 18th shot, where we have our bronze medalists, and after the 20th, we have our gold and silver medalists. I'm Hillary Russell, and have the pleasure of having Trinidad and Tobago's pistol shooter, Roger Daniel, here with us today. Welcome, Roger, and thanks so much for joining us.
Good morning. Good day, everyone.
It's really nice to have you here. It's been a while since we've had a chance to sit down and commentate together.
Yes, I know. It's been a long time.
And so tell me what's been going on in your life.
Yeah, I've had a few changes made to my equipment. Basically, I've been resting, trying to get the family life in order. Mm-hmm. And then I say, hey, time to pick back up from where we start off, and got new equipment, and I'm back at it again.
And are you liking the new equipment? Is it working out for you?
Yeah, a bit challenging at first, but like everything else, you have to be patient with it and give it time to settle back in.
Great. What other World Cups will you be attending this year?
I plan to go to Germany, and after that we have the Caribbean Championships. Mm-hmm. And from there I plan to attend the World Masters in Italy.
Great. That'll be wonderful. It'll be nice to have you in our country.
Thank you very much. It's a pleasure.
So these guys are just doing some sighting time right now, and in a couple of minutes we'll have a chance to introduce them.
Seconds to go, 40 seconds.
Yeah. You know, there's three of the eight finalists that are representing Russia today, which just goes to show what a strong team that they have.
They usually do.
Yeah. And we've got a couple guys in here that have never entered into a final round of a World Cup before either. So it will prove to be very interesting because, as I was just saying, everyone starts off with zero.
Yes.
And what do you think? What do you think about the new finals format? Do you like watching them?
I love it.
You do?
I plan to be in there soon because I seem to love being in finals. Mm-hmm. Have to work to get there right now, but I love the finals. I love the new format. It's very interesting. You know, it's really, really interesting.
Great. Okay, so the sighting time has finished, and we'll have a chance to introduce these eight fine athletes. On firing point H, representing the Russian Federation, we have Vladimir Isakov. He's probably the most experienced shooter that we have here today. Wouldn't you say that?
Yes, very true. I realize he's my age too.
As you can see, he was the Olympic Games bronze medalist back in 2004, a four-time World Cup gold medalist, a one-time World Cup final gold medalist as well. So he really has got a lot of experience behind him.
Very true. Started out watching this guy, you know.
On firing point G, also representing the Russian Federation, we have Denis KOULAKOV. He was the junior world champion back in 2002, and a one-time World Cup bronze medalist. On firing point F, representing Brazil, we have Felipe Almeida Wu.
First time.
This is first time, exactly.
Junior as well.
He did win the silver medal during the Youth Olympic Games 2010. Then, in firing line E, representing the United States of America, we've got Will Brown.
He's improving more and more. Every time I see him now, he's just improving more and more. It's amazing.
Fantastic. On firing point D, representing Germany, we have Florian Schmidt. This is a man that we've seen around for a while now.
I hope this is his time now.
Exactly.
He's been there, fonging at the door.
On firing point C, representing the People's Republic of China, we have Pu Tifung. He was the gold medalist during the World Championships in 2006.
Asian Games as well. Great.
On firing point B, representing the Russian Federation, we have Leonid Ekimov.
Yeah, no stranger to the finals.
This is another one that we have seen around. He actually won the gold medal during the World Cup final last year in Bangkok.
Wow.
And on firing line A, representing the Ukraine, we have Oleh Omelchuk. He actually made it into the Olympic Games, into the final there, placed fifth. So I'm sure that he's very, very driven to come home with a medal this time, no?
It'll be very interesting.
And as you can see, we've got the president of the ISSF here, Mr. Vasco Stranja. Yeah. It's always nice to have him here.
Now, I like the support that they come out and they mingle with the people and they talk and, you know, share ideas. I actually spoke with them yesterday and it was so amazing.
Really?
Yeah, you learn a lot actually, you know. Seeing people, you talk to them and you interact and everything, you just learn more and more every day.
You've got a great way of looking at things there, I have to say. Roger, you really have a way of putting positivity into everything. And that's what we love, you know.
I agree with that. And I try to do that every day and also spread it on to the younger ones at home.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, you try to be positive as much as possible, whether things may be going not your way, but still stay positive and who knows, we'll look up for you.
That's right.
Mm-hmm.
So we're going to get on to the first series. Again, it's three shots that the gentlemen have 150 seconds to shoot at these three shots. And you really have to kind of go into this really strong.
Yes, I'm prepared, very much prepared. Physically and mentally.
We saw you doing a little bit of training before you sat down to commentate with me. Seems like you're always on the run there.
I had to warm up. Don't want to pull a muscle. Yeah.
So it's really anybody's game right now. Everyone's starting off with zero.
That makes it so interesting.
It makes it great to watch. You know, yesterday during the women's event, at the very last score, at the last shot, they ended up in a shoot-off.
Really?
And so it was fantastic, yeah.
Wow, that was amazing. Wow.
Okay.
That's good.
Isakov is really just taking his time here.
Anybody's race. I like to see his composure.
He's just about as steady as you get. You know, like we were saying, he's a very, very experienced shooter.
I think maybe all the Russians will pull each other here, you know, just being there. I wonder if they train together.
It would be amazing if they overtook the whole podium, you know?
That would be amazing.
That would be an amazing day for the Russian Federation, without a doubt.
Well, it's about to stop that.
Now, like you said, this Will Brown, you've been taking a look and watching over him.
I've been watching him and since Pan American Games in Mexico.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, I had a chance of competing against him. I won the silver medal, but he didn't place, but he was close. So from then on, every time I watch the world rankings or the World Cups, I realize he's improving more and more. I think he's a person to watch in the future, and he's young.
And also we have KOULAKOV, who is shooting extremely well today. Isakov has finished up. This is Wu. This is a gentleman from Brazil. We don't oftentimes see Brazilians entering into finals, so this is great
true.
To see.
Yes. He himself, he has improved a lot. I mean, last time I saw him, he's constantly climbing, so I wish him all the best.
Great. Yeah, Florian Schmidt finishing off with 29.1
very
points.
Very close.
And Omelchuk was 30.4, so let's just take a look after the first series. We have Isakov holding on to first place by a mere 0.6 of a point over his teammate, KOULAKOV. Omelchuk is only 0.1 of a point behind KOULAKOV. And Wu, it's so incredibly close here. Everyone is just 0.1 of a point behind each other.
It's going to be very interesting.
So we have another three shots, another series of three. And then we're going to get into the elimination. Into the elimination.
This is very interesting.
Now, have you been practicing the new finals format as well?
No, I haven't had the opportunity. I just went into competition and learned about it.
Wow.
So, but you know, like it's everything, it's a mental. So once you understand it, you could just apply it and train for it. Mm-hmm. So that's what I'm about to do from now on.
Perfect. Let's take a look now at the People's Republic of China's Fu. He has been in a World Cup before in a final round.
Times.
In 2010, it looks like it was the only time that he, well, for this discipline at least, mm-hmm. has entered into a final round. And let's take a look here at little Will Brown.
Yeah, Will is really going.
Yeah, he's got the pressure of shooting on his own home turf, but he seems like he's holding up to it pretty well.
I think so.
Back on now to Ekimov.
So far, so good.
He's another one who I really enjoy watching. You know, his concentration is mm-hmm. something else. When you take a look at his eyes when he's shooting, you can tell he is completely in the zone and really focusing in on what's at stake.
Yes, I really admire watching the Russian guys. They're so amazing to watch when they're shooting. The level of concentration. Mm-hmm. He doesn't seem to, but it looks
like he doesn't look like he's thrilled with that shot, but you know, anything can happen here. Again, now on mm-hmm. to Omelchuk.
10.3, beautiful. That's what you want. You want the tens.
Exactly. Yuzikov still is holding on to first place.
And
Pooh is holding on to sixth place right now. So let's take a look again. We've got Isakov still holding on to first place. He's really made a stride forward. He's ahead by 1 point. Omelchuk in second place. He's overtaken and moved up the scoreboard. And he's holding on to that only by 1/10 of a point.
Not much.
The person that looks like they could be in a little bit of trouble now is Wu from Brazil. He, after we've got this shot and then the next one and then whoever is going to be eliminated. And he's 1.8 of a point in eighth place. Nothing is impossible.
That is true.
You know, so he could come back from that. We'll just have to see how the others are shooting against him.
All right, so they have 45 seconds remaining for the shot. They have 50 seconds each for each shot.
Let's see here how Wu can get back into this game.
Oh,
10.6, that's great. Fantastic shooting for Wu. He just has to keep up. Come off with a 10.8.
Wow.
That's a really, really nice
shot.
And there he is right there, Ekimov with a 10.8. Isakov still is holding on to first place by 8/10 of a point. Omelchuk in second place still by 1/2 of a point. And we have Koulakov and Brown both tied up. And behind them, we've got Florian Schmidt, who's only 1/10 of a point behind. One more shot before our first person is eliminated, and Wu is the one that looks like he's in risk right now. He's 1 point behind.
He has the hope. He has a lot of hoping to do.
That's right. A lot of.
But anything could happen here. It's a sport of shooting.
And the thing is, they all know exactly where they're standing. They all have scoreboards that are over their heads so they can see what's going on with the others.
Concentration again. Let's see what he gets.
A 10.2.
Oh.
And it's just not enough. Nope, it isn't. He still is 1 point behind, and that is going to be the first person out of this final.
Good effort.
Let's take take a look and see if we can see him. There he is.
Yes, there he is.
Excellent, excellent job getting into the final
today.
Yeah, I mean, my hat definitely goes off to him.
So that was a great effort. I can be pleased.
It doesn't look very happy.
Yeah,
now.
It doesn't.
Well, I can understand that, but you know, he's got the future ahead of him.
That is true.
Anything can happen. We do have Isakov now making a stride again forward, 1.7 tenths of a point ahead. And now we've got Pooh, who is the one who is in danger. He's 6 tenths of a point behind Schmidt. 6 tenths of a point.
Yes, not much.
Not much.
The air is getting rare. There we see them.
You know, the Chinese team, you always, it seems like we always see somebody from China in the finals.
That's what is amazing.
9.0, that's not.
It's going to be costly.
Yes, we're going to take a look at with Schmidt shooting a 10.1. There's, you know, he's really got one more shot to make up for that 9.0, but I'm not sure if he's got it in.
Oh, 1.7, that's going to be.
So you can see Akimov has lost a little bit of his lead once again, but he's still ahead by 7 tenths of a point. And he is holding on to that over Akimov and Olmechuk, who are now tied up for second place. Only a half a point behind is Kulikov. We have Pooh, who is in seventh place, and he's down by 1.7 tenths of a point.
Yeah, it's anybody's race right here, but no. Watching Will and the Russians. The Russians are bunching already.
They really are.
Yeah, so it's going to be very interesting. Let me see Pooh.
We've got Pooh here, like I said, 1.7 tenths of a point behind, and somebody's got to be eliminated after this shot. And 9.6, that's not going to do it.
Yeah.
Especially with Florian Schmidt shooting a 10.1 and holding on to sixth place right now.
Yep.
So in fact, we're going to have to say goodbye to the People's Republic of China's Pooh. And take a look and see what's going on. Akimov has now taken over. He is in first place by 2 tenths of a point. Will Brown has moved up into second place. Isakov has moved down, but he's tied up with Brown. I mean, this is such an incredibly tight final.
It is.
You know, it's anybody's game, without a doubt. Yeah. The only one that's down a bit is Florian Schmidt from Germany. He's down by a point. And he's the one who we're going to have to keep an eye on to see if he'll be the next one to be eliminated or not.
To make each shot count here, right? About now. The intense concentration.
Well, 9.9.
He doesn't look too pleased about that.
But we've got Brown, who just shot a 10.8. That's not a bad way to go. Kulikov with a 10.4. That has moved Will Brown up into first place by 4 tenths of a point over Isakov. Olmechuk is in third place by 3 tenths of a point. And we've got Schmidt now 1.4 tenths of a point and in sixth place. And he, I'm afraid, will be the one who's going to be eliminated now.
Oh, he has one more, and then you have to make it count.
So this Will Brown, he's really surprising me here, you know?
Yes, he is. He has improved a lot.
I guess he has. Shooting a 10.8, that's the way you do it. That's the way you climb right up.
Yes.
I was kind of surprised there by Isakov. I kind of thought that he had it in the bag from the beginning, but I mean, we still have
it's
some...
anybody's race right to vote? No.
Right.
So the guy trying to stay in...
10.6, nice work by Florian Schmidt.
Let's see if it keeps in hand.
Whoa!
It does!
What is happening here? Akimov with a shot of 8.8 has moved him down into sixth place by 4 tenths of a point over Schmidt.
And he's out.
Unbelievable.
He's out with that 8.
Unreal. Akimov is, he is out and he's not looking at all happy with that.
No.
Understandably.
Unbelievable.
We still have Will Brown. He's holding on to first place by a half of a point now. Omelchuk is in third only by 1/10 of a point. And Schmidt was saved there. He was really saved. He's only a half a point behind Koulakov. And these next two shots are going to find out between the two of them who is going to be eliminated, I believe.
That was an amazing twist.
That was a fate, wasn't
unbelievable.
It?
Unbelievable.
Here he is, Will Brown from the USA.
See that shake there.
You can see his hands moving, shaking just a bit there. He knows where, well,
beautiful
not shaking
shot.
Too much. 10.3. Schmidt with a 9.7. And just waiting now on Isakov.
Yes, 13 seconds remaining for the shot.
Oh, whoa. An 8.3 for Isakov. Let's take a look here. We've got one more shot before the fifth place is going to be eliminated, and that is being held by Florian Schmidt only by 1/10 of a point behind Isakov.
This is an amazing twist of
an 8.3. I'm kind of wondering what's going on there. We still have Will Brown holding on to first place. He's got it by one solid point.
Very composed.
And we still have things going on. He's new to the finals. But let's just see if he can keep it up. You know, he's got the pressure of all of his teammates,
true,
you know, watching him. But he's really holding up very, very well. All right, these are the two that are fighting it off right now for to stay into the game. Florian Schmidt, Vladimir Isakov. Schmidt with a 10.2, Isakov a 10.0.
Oh my gosh, it looks like Vlad Isakov.
So yeah.
Yeah, Russia is out by 0.1.
One.
Oh my. Oh my
God. There he is. Isakov is out. He started off strong. He was in first place and ended up in fifth place. Florian Schmidt is really putting up a fight here. You know, I thought he was going to be out early on into this.
He's really fighting.
He's really fighting hard. he is holding on to fourth place only by 3/10 of a point.
Unbelievable. This has totally twisted around that he was expecting. You know?
Two more shots to find out who's going to be going in and fighting out for the medals. Will Brown holding on to first by 8/10 of a point.
Really showing his form.
Florian Schmidt has basically planned on being out after that 8.5. Very unfortunate shot for Florian Schmidt.
Yes.
He's now 1.3/10 of a point. And Omelchuk has now overtaken Brown by 3/10 of a point. It's really,
anybody's race right about here now.
Absolutely anybody's race. Koulakov is 2.7/10 of a point behind Brown. And like we said, with that 8.5 for Schmidt, that's not going to help things out, but he's done a great job climbing up the scoreboard. And look at his face.
Let's see if his luck holds. He's been doing that since from the seventh position, so he's been climbing. So let's see what happens here.
I can't imagine it's very easy to come off of an 8.5. You know, mentally, you have to really clear it right out.
To lift yourself.
A 10.1. Oh, unbelievable. We've got Omelchuk, who has shot a 9.2. Changing things around again. Schmidt, we're going to have to say.
Yeah, goodbye to.
Yeah.
The Schmidt.
He did put up a great fight.
Ended
up in fourth place.
That was commendable.
And yeah, he really did. I mean, he finished off only 8/10 of a point behind third place. We've got Will Brown, who has overtaken Omelchuk once again. He's 8/10 of a point ahead.
Really holding his form.
And Koulakov, he's the one that we're going to have to take a look at. He looks like he's going to be the bronze medalist, but you never know. If these guys are shooting in the eights, you never know what's going to happen. Koulakov is 2.6/10 of a point behind Omelchuk.
50 seconds for shot.
Back on now to Brown. Really just has to keep it strong, keep on doing what he's doing. Mm-hmm. It's a little bit shaky there.
One movement.
Yes.
9.2.
But it's all right because Omelchuk also shot a 9.2, so nothing's changed for their standings.
1.4 to the leader and 0.8 second.
Koulakov, actually, he grabbed a little bit of points there. He's still 1.4 tenth of a point behind Omelchuk. And like I said, Brown and Omelchuk, their standings didn't change at all. Both of them shooting a 9.2.
This is what makes the air red right about now.
Again, on to Koulakov. At least one of the three from the Russian Federation will end up on the podium.
Concentration deep in.
A 10.1, that's not going to do it. Our bronze medalist, Denis Koulakov from the Russian Federation. He put up a great fight. Omelchuk, who shot a 9.5, Brown shot a 10.2, and we've got Brown with a 1.5 point advantage right now over Omelchuk. I'm not putting my money down on anybody at this point.
As long as really holding it, I'm really at my own.
Well, I can tell you, the crowd is going to go crazy. If Will can pull this off and end up with a gold medal, what a great experience and
yes,
a great.
It will be. The experience guy here. Yeah.
In fact, Omelchuk, much more experienced than Brown is.
But it's anybody's race right about now. Brown with a beautiful 10.
He's putting more distance behind him. A 9.8 for Omelchuk, a 10.2 for Brown. He's almost 2 points ahead, and there's just one more shot to go. We've seen it happen in the past. The pressure's on for the last shot. And you say, no, what has just happened there? He
that
had the gold,
one.
You know? Okay, the pressure is on Brown. Like I said, almost 2 points.
So far he's been handling it.
I
think he could handle it.
I think he's got it. I think it's going to be on the highest step today. Mm-hmm. Making the USA a very proud nation once again.
Yes. Cheney's got what it takes to be here.
Oh, Brown finishing off with a 9.0.
But it's enough.
Of course it is. Omelchuk with an 8.3. Unbelievable. Will Brown winning the gold medal. Like we said, the last shot, you know, an 8.3, the nerves get to you or something strange goes
well
wrong.
Well done, Brown. Will Brown.
Will Brown winning his very first World Cup medal, the shiniest one of all, the gold.
Yes.
And our silver medalist is Oleh Omelchuk from the Ukraine. Will Brown, there he is. I'm sure that many people in the crowd would like to give him a great big congratulations.
That is true.
He's really, really thrilled with that, as well he should be.
He's consistent
there
from the start to the end.
Our silver medalist, Omelchuk from the Ukraine. He put up a good fight. That last shot, there was no chance to catch up with Brown.
That is amazing.
And once again, we've had Denis Koulakov from the Russian Federation, who is our bronze medalist today. God, Roger, it was so nice to have you here with me and
thanks
commentating. I wish you all the very, very best for the future.
Thank you very much.
Look forward to seeing you at the World Cups.
All right, thank you. I'm looking to be in the footsteps of the finalists here.
That's
soon.
Right. Next time, I want to be commentating on you winning the gold, okay?
Okay, I will.
Okay.
Thank you.
Your bronze medalist, representing the Russian Federation, Denis Kulakov. Your silver medalist, representing the Ukraine, OMELCHUK Oleh. Your gold medalist, representing the United States of America, Will Brown. Ladies and gentlemen, please rise for the national anthem of the United States of America.
Can you guys step up all together, please? Thank you.